station. It's time, get up and shout. I wonder what we'll learn about. Blippi Wonders! Wow! Look at those birds! Oh! Wow! Look at all these animals we're finding! Maybe we'll find the king of the jungle next. Ah! That's not the king of the jungle.
King of the jungle? Wait, are you looking for a lion? There's not really any lions in the jungle. You gotta go to the savannah for that. Out there!
I wonder, why are lions called the king of the jungle? Lion! Cool! Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Tabbs.
Hello, Blippi and Tabbs. I'm Jabari, the king of the jungle. I was just sharpening my kingly skills on the lion obstacle course.
The lion obstacle course? That's so cool!
Would you like to train with me? If you complete the course, I'll make you honorary lions!
Yeah!
Our first lesson is here, where you will learn to sneak like a lion.
Sneak like a lion. Got it.
Shh. Not so loud, Blippi. You will scare off the prey.
The prey?
The prey is the butterfly.
Oh, I get it. Sneaky.
Not bad for a first try.
Yeah.
Let's try the next lesson. Jumping! Crouch down and feel your energy. Then, when you are ready, release the energy and jump!
Are you ready, Tabs? Jump like a lion!
Yes! Great job! Now there's one more lesson. Hop on my back and hang on tight!
Yay!
Welcome to the roaring arena. To roar like a lion, follow along. First, find your power. Lift up and roar! Way to go, Blippi and Tabbs. You are now honorary lions.
Thanks, Jabari. We had so much fun. And I got the answer to my question. Why are lions called the king of the jungle? Even though lions are called king of the jungle, they actually live on the savannah. Lions are sneaky hunters, big jumpers, and have really loud roars. Upload answer, Tabs. See you next time we're in the savannah, Jabari.
Goodbye, Blippi and Tabs. Come back and roar with me anytime.
Whoa! Bouncy sand dune. And even bouncier. Wow, what an amazing sandcastle. Wave incoming! Oh no, looks like that castle was no match for that wave. Huh, I wonder, can I build a sandcastle that doesn't get washed away? Yeah, you're right, Tabs. There is only one way to find out. I need to build a sandcastle of my own. I'm gonna need the excavator arm and spider legs.
Excavator arm, spider legs, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi Mobile is ready for action. Let's go make a sandcastle that won't get washed away. Now we need to make ourselves sandcastle size. Shrinking down. feel that cool ocean breeze, Tabs. Whoa!
Hi there! I'm Krabby the Crab. Pleasure to meet you. Ooh, crikey! I don't know my own strength.
Hi, Krabby. It's me, Blippi. And this is my Blippi-mobile.
I love it.
So, you out taking a fun ride?
Actually, Krabby, I'm here because I'm curious if I can build a sandcastle that won't get washed away.
You came to the right crab. I'm a planner, digger, and a builder. I can help you, Blippi.
Great.
So the first thing we're gonna do is build a moat. That's a fancy word for a hole. You see, the water goes into the hole and doesn't wash away what's behind it. So, let's dig. Dig, 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 dig.
Wow, what a hole.
Now let's build a sandcastle.
You're right, Tabs. We are gonna need a shovel.
Finished! Success!
You already built it, Krabby.
And our moat is perfect. The moat's the hole we dug all around the sandcastle.
Great moat! And best sandcastle ever. Wave incoming! The moat worked, Krabby. This means I think I have the answer to my question. Can I build a sandcastle that doesn't get washed away? I can by making a hole around it to catch the water. Upload answer, Tabs. Thanks, Krabby.
See you later, Blippi. Keep on digging.
Whoa, Tabs, that bouncy castle is out of this world. I wonder, what would it be like to bounce on the moon? Great idea, Tabs. We can go to the moon and find out. I'm gonna need a rocket booster, excavator arm, and frog legs.
Jets, excavator arm, frog legs, confirmed.
Okay, let's go explore. The Blippi-mobile is ready to blast off for adventure. And there's the moon! Yeah! Okay, time to land.
Hey, that tickles!
Who are you?
My name's Rocky the Moon Rock because I'm a rock.
Hey, Rocky. It's me, Blippi, and this is Tabs. We're here to find out what it's like to bounce on the moon.
I never tried it myself, being a rock, but let me see if I can just get up.
All right, then let's bounce.
Cha-cha-cha-cha-cha, I'm light as a feather up here. I never knew I could have been having so much fun!
Woohoo! It's amazing that we're staying up here this long. Why does it take so long to float down?
Because of gravity! It's the invisible force that keeps your moon boots on the ground. It pulls things back down. But there's way less gravity around the moon than on Earth because the moon is so much smaller.
That's why we float for so long. I have the answer to my question. What would it be like to bounce on the moon? It's so fun, and the bounces are really big because there's less gravity on the moon than there is on Earth. Upload answer, Tabs. We feel like we're floating, but gravity is slowly pulling us back down.
Cha, 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 cha. Thanks for the greatest time that I, Rocky the Moon Rock, ever had.
Bye, Rocky!
Keep on bouncing, Blippi!
Whoa!
Activate Blippi Station! It's time, get up and shout. I wonder what we'll learn about. Blippi!
Salad! Oh, thanks, Tabs. Didn't know this lettuce was stuck in my teeth. I guess a toothbrush would help. I wonder, how do you use a toothbrush to clean your teeth? Great idea! We can go meet a toothbrush in a mouth. I'm gonna need wings.
Wings confirmed.
Let's go explore! Activate Blippi Station! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. It's time to shrink down and go into a mouth. Shrinking down! We're inside a mouth. You're right, Tabs. We need a way to clean these teeth.
Would a brush help? Hi, I'm Bill Brushy. And you are?
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Tabs. I want to find out how to use a toothbrush to clean teeth.
Well, you're asking the right brush. Hop on, and I'll show you the best way to clean your teeth.
All right. Hey, Bill Brushy, is that toothpaste on your brush part?
Yes, sir. It helps keep teeth healthy and food free. Okay, now here's how to brush your teeth. Let's go to the front first. So, small circles on every tooth.
Whoa!
Okay, that's the front done. Let's go to the back now.
We turned, we flipped.
Little circles round and round.
All right, let's make some more. Circles, circles, circles.
These teeth are the molars. I call them the chew crew, since they do most of the work.
I know, Tabs. Toothbrushing is a wild ride. Wow! I think I have the answer to my question. How do you use a toothbrush to clean your teeth? It cleans by brushing the front, back, and in between of all teeth in little circle motions. And that pushes all the food out from between the teeth and makes them nice and clean. Upload answer, Tabs.
Thanks for your help, Blippi and Tabs. Remember to brush twice a day for 2 minutes each time for super sparkling teeth.
We will. Thanks for letting us ride along, Brushy. Bye-bye. Wow, that bee sure seems busy. And so does that one. And that one too. They're all so busy. Well, except that one. Those bees are busy making honey. I wonder, how do bees make honey? Yes, let's go into the beehive. I'm gonna need wings and the excavator arm.
Wings, excavator arm, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. Now, we just need to make like a bee and be tinier. Shrinking down! You're right, Tabs. The bee's tongue is in the flower. Hey, it's me, Blippi. This is Tabs. I was wondering how you make honey.
Hey, Blippi, I'm Bijon. Honey, huh? This is the place to be. So I'm using my tongue to drink in this sweet nectar. It's how we bees start to make honey. Okay, time to buzz. Into the beehive. Follow me. Spoiler, lots of bees working. It's like a honey factory in there.
Bijan, are they all chewing nectar?
Sure are. Gotta chew, that's what we do. Chewing makes it thicker. Can't have runny honey. I rhymed again!
And after you chew, then you have honey?
No, there's more to show. We chew, then we swallow. The nectar stays in our bellies, becomes honey, then we put it in the honeycomb.
The honeycomb?
Yep, we store the honey in the honeycomb.
Maybe I can taste some honey.
Oh dear. This may look funny, but flapping our wings is how we make thicker honey. It's a bee thing.
Whoa! Yes, Tabs, I have the answer to my question. How do bees make honey? They get nectar from flowers, chew it, store it in their stomachs, then put the honey in a honeycomb and flap their wings over it. Upload answer, Tabs. Bye, Bijan. Thanks for being you.
Bye.
Yeah. Wow, that's a pretty tall mountain. I'm sure there are way taller mountains, Tabs. I wonder, what's the tallest mountain in the world? Great idea, Tabs. We'll go to the Himalayas and find out. I'm gonna need wings and the grabber arm.
Wings, grabber arm, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. Let's go find the tallest mountain in the world. Woohoo! Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Tabs. We're looking for the tallest mountain.
I'm climbing it right now. Hi, I'm Betty the Yeti.
Yeti!
I was just headed to the top. That's where the best snow is. Nothing worse than old snow.
Can I tag along? I want to see what it's like on top of the tallest mountain.
Of course, but get ready. This mountain is super tall! Woo-hoo-hoo!
We're up so high, and it's much colder up here. Thanks, Tabs. I love hot cocoa.
Whoa!
Woo! Gotcha. Phew. That was a close one. Hey, it's the mountaintop. Yeah, we made it. Oh, whoa! It's so windy up here!
I got you, Blippi!
So, what is the name of this mountain?
It's Himalaya! Oh, you call it Mount Everest.
You're right, Tabs. I have the answer to my question. What's the tallest mountain in the world? It's Mount Everest! It's 29,035 feet tall. Upload answer, Tabs.
And the snow up here is delicious. Snow burps.
Have a good snow snack. Bye, Betty the Yeti.
Bye, Blippi.
I love being at the beach. Whoa! A flying fish! I wonder, what's underneath the ocean? Good idea, Tabs. We can go into the ocean and find out. I'll need duck feet and a propeller.
Duck feet, propeller, confirmed.
activate Blippi Station. The Blippi Mobile is ready for adventure. Wow! It's a whole other world down here. Is this like some kind of underwater forest?
Exactly! It is a forest! Welcome to my neighborhood! My name's Jerry, Jerry the Jellyfish!
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Tabs. We're down here to see what's in the ocean.
Oh yeah, there's a lot. The ocean's full of surprises. I'll show you. I'm going to meet my friends. Well, I'll give you a tour along the way.
All right, thanks, Jerry.
First stop, our kelp forest. This kelp can grow up to 150 feet.
Wow, that's so tall.
Oh yeah, but sometimes the water current around here blows the kelp around.
Kelp! Kelp!
Oh no, this never happens.
Great idea, Tabs. Let's use the turbo boosters.
Oh good, glad you're okay. Let's move on.
Whoa, that fish is blue and has a long nose.
She's a blue marlin. She uses her nose to find and catch food. She's also really fast.
Whoa.
Oh no, this never happens.
Yeah, Tabs, it is dark in here. Wherever we are. Jerry!
Jerry?
Blippi, is that you in there? Oh no, hold on. Whoa! I scared a gray whale? And she blew you right out of her blowhole? That never happens.
Thanks for getting us out of there, Jerry. Oh, you're all lit up.
I told you the ocean was full of surprises, didn't I?
Hey, look, it's your friends.
Hiya, pals. You guys found me.
And I found the answer to my question. What's underneath the ocean? There's a kelp forest, blue marlins, huge whales, and a jellyfish that lights up. Upload answer, Tabs.
And we're only on chapter one. In chapter two, there's an octopus and a shark and a sea turtle and a tuna.
Bye, Jerry.
Oh, and there's an otter and a seahorse and a lobster and a stingray.
Look at that snowflake.
Whoa.
I agree, Debo. Snowflakes are beautiful. I wonder, how is a snowflake made? You're right, Debo. We can go up into a cloud and find out. I'm going to need a grabber arm and wings.
Grabber arm, wings, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi Mobile is ready for adventure. Let's go find out how a snowflake is made. We're way up high, and the air is very cold.
Isn't it so chill? I mean, welcome to my cloud.
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Debo. It looks like you're working hard.
You're right. I'm a small particle now, but soon I'll be a big snowflake. Can you pass me those big water vapor clouds? The water in the cloud freezes on me, and then I grow more crystals. One snowflake can contain as many as 100 ice crystals!
All of those ice crystals sure made you strong, Mimi.
Here.
Yeah.
Go catch, Debo. Now that I'm heavy enough, I can fall towards the ground. Follow me.
Yay!
Mimi, each time water vapor sticks to you and becomes ice crystals, you get even bigger and more impressive.
Thanks.
You have 6 points, same as every other snowflake, but your own one-of-a-kind design.
Yep, no two snowflakes are alike. That means there's no one like me. That's why I'm called Mimi, a snowman. Perfect. I can land there with the rest of my squad. I did it. Stuck the landing.
Way to go, Mimi. And I have the answer to my question. How is a snowflake made? It starts as a particle in the air and collects ice crystals as it gets colder and colder, eventually forming a unique snowflake. Upload answer, Debo. Bye-bye, Mimi.
Bye, Blippi.
I see the moon, stars, and is that a planet? Oh, it is, Tabs. Whoa, there's a whole area out there in space with the planets and the sun. It's called the solar system. I wonder, what planets are in the solar system? Good idea, Tabs. Let's go into outer space. I'm gonna need a rocket booster.
Rocket booster.
Activate Blippi Station. Now it's time to get planet size. Growing up. Right, Tabs, we're in space. Whoa, it's a meteor. Hey, it's me, Blippi.
Welcome to outer space. I'm Mary the Meteor.
I'm here to find out about all the planets in our solar system.
There are 8 planets in our solar system. Let's meet them, shall we? Closest to the blazing sun are the 2 smallest and hottest planets, Mercury and Venus.
Whoa, that is hot.
We should go. The 3rd planet is your home, Earth.
Hi, Mom.
Then there's Mars, the red planet. Mars is red because it's covered in rusty soil.
That's a lot of dust.
Come on. Next up is the giant Jupiter, bigger than all the planets combined. He doesn't scare me, though. Whoa, we should go.
We sure are a long way from the sun now.
Welcome to Saturn and her rings.
Whoa, they look beautiful. Can we get closer?
Of course.
Whoa.
Yeah, wee. Wait, we haven't finished yet. On your left is Uranus, billions of miles from the sun, pretty cold. Now let's hear it for the furthest, windiest, and coldest planet, Neptune!
Blippi?
Whoa! I have the answer to my question. What planets are in our solar system? Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Upload answer, Tabs. Thanks for the tour, Mary. That was wild.
See ya, Blippi. Time for a shower. A meteor shower!
Bye, Mary the Meteor. I love chocolate. Just a little bit now and then. Do you love it too, Debo? Oh, right. Dogs can't have chocolate. It hurts their tummies. I wonder, how are chocolate bars made? Great idea! We can go into that chocolate factory and find out. I'm gonna need wings, hovercraft, and a prop engine.
Wings, hovercraft, prop engine, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. Shrinking down! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. Let's go meet some chocolate bars in the chocolate factory.
Hey there! You're not Cocoa Beans!
I need them so we can start making chocolate bars!
I'm not a bean, it's me, Blippi! And this is Debo!
Hi, Blippi! Hi, Debo! I'm Barb the Chocolate Bar. Welcome to my chocolate factory!
Thanks, Barb! I'd love to see how chocolate bars are made! Can we come with you?
Absolutely! It all begins with cocoa beans. These beans come from plants.
So, how do beans become a chocolate bar?
They go on a little journey. First, a bean bath. Next, our beans get roasty and toasty. Then they get made into teeny-weeny beans. Our bean powder then gets mixed with sugar and milk to make them sweet and smooth.
Woohoo! Come on, Debo, time to ski! No, but it'll be fun! It's Chocolate Bar Debo!
After the chocolate is cooled into bar shapes, we wrap them and they're ready! Ta-da!
Whoa! You both look alike! And I have the answer to my question. How are chocolate bars made? Cocoa beans get washed, heated, crunched, mixed with milk and sugar, and then cooled down into a chocolate bar. Upload answer, Debo. Thanks for a sweet tour, Barb.
Anytime. Bye, Blippi.
Bye-bye. Mmm, what's better than a delicious piece of fruit? You're right, Debo. Vegetables are yummy too. I wonder, what's the difference between fruits and vegetables? Super suggestion. We'll go into that garden to figure it out. I'm gonna need wings and a grabber arm.
Wings, grabber arm, confirmed.
Okie dokie, artichokey. Activate Blippi Station. Shrinking down! The Blippi Mobile is ready for adventure. All right, we're in a community garden where all kinds of fruits and vegetables grow. Look, there's one right now.
Step right up. You're the next contestant on Slim Cucumber Certified Fresh Game Show.
Fruit or vegetable?
Tell us your names.
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Debo.
Now, Blippi and Debo, a quick review before we start. All fruits have a pit or seeds in them and grow on a plant with flowers.
Fruits have pits or seeds and always flowers. Got it.
And vegetables are different. There are root and leaves.
Got that too.
Excellent. Let's play. Tell me, Blippi, is this carrot a fruit?
Ooh, the carrot is a vegetable because it's a root and has leaves.
That's right! But can Blippi go 2 for 2? So tell me, is this tomato a fruit or a vegetable?
This is tough. Okay, a tomato grows from a plant, but it has seeds. It's also a vegetable?
Oh, sorry. Tomato is a fruit. Now, your final question, Blippi. Can you tell me if this strawberry is a fruit or vegetable?
Strawberry is a fruit.
Yes, strawberry is a fruit. And you got 2 correct answers, which means this trophy is all yours.
Thanks, Mr. Slim.
And I also have the answer to my question. What's the difference between fruits and vegetables? Vegetables are roots and leaves, and fruits have flowers and a pit or seeds. Upload answer, Debo. Bye-bye, Mr. Slim.
Congrats to you, Blippi. That's our game. I'm Slim the Cucumber, and by the way, I'm a fruit. Tune in next time for our special guest, Madam Mango, on Fruit of Vegetables.
You're right, Debo. This is a kangaroo crossing, and we are in Australia. So, I guess you never know when a kangaroo might... Whoa! Bounce in! Wow! What a spectacular jump! I wonder, how high can a kangaroo jump? Great idea! We'll go ask that kangaroo. I'm gonna need frog legs for this adventure.
Frog legs, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure! We're in the outback, so let's go find a kangaroo!
Oh, hi there! I'm Rooney! What brings you to these parts in your cool-looking car?
Hi, Rooney! It's me, Blippi! And this is Debo. We wanted to see how high a kangaroo can jump.
Pleasure to meet ya. Well, I can jump as high as your mobile here, but I can jump higher.
Whoa, Rooney's hopping pretty high and super fast.
Ah, you're pretty fast yourself. You up for a little race, Blippi?
Sounds fun.
All right, let's race around that big sandstone rock down there. We call it Uluru, or Ayers Rock. It's the heart of Australia.
Whoa, so cool.
And the first bag here wins.
You're on, Rooney.
By the way, there may be a fence or two in the way.
Good to know. The best jumper we've ever seen! And now I have the answer to my question. How high can a kangaroo jump? Kangaroos can jump up to 10 feet off the ground. Upload answer, Debo.
That was fun, Blippi. Whew, gotta cool down. That's why I'm licking my arm. It's a kangaroo thing. Bye!
Bye-bye! Spiderweb looks amazing! You're right, Debo! Spiderwebs do have such artistic designs! I wonder, how do spiders make their webs? Yes! Let's go find a spider to ask! I'm gonna need wings and spider legs!
Wings, spider legs, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station! Shrinking down! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure!
Bonjour! I'm Spencer! You're just in time to watch me make my latest artistic creation!
Hey! It's me, Blippi! Are you about to make a web?
I am! It's going to be my greatest masterpiece! The webbiest web of all time! Want to help?
Yeah! I really want to learn how spiders make their webs.
Time to create!
Debo, I'll be right back.
Blippi, you can be my holder and tester. My web will be a circle-shaped design with some triangles in the middle.
What kind of string do you use to make your web?
I use silk strands that I make myself, and they shoot out of my stomach. To a spider or bug, these strands are as strong as steel.
That is so cool!
Next, the circles to complete my masterpiece. Can you hold this strand in place, Blippi?
Yeah! Whoa! It is a circle shape!
Ah, perfect! Grab that strand, Blippi, to swing out for a look!
Whoa! Amazing! Wait! Is that a picture of me in your web?
It is you, my masterpiece. Now you can test it. Bounce against it. See if it holds.
Whee! Whoa!
The sticky part is for catching bugs to eat.
Your web is beautiful and useful, Spencer. And you answer my question. How do spiders make their webs? They use super strong and sticky silk strands to create a web with a cool circular design. Upload answer, Debo. Thanks for showing us how you make a perfect web, Spencer. Bye-bye.
Au revoir.
Yum. These turkey sandwiches are going to be delicious. What a mess! Hey, look at that fly walk on the ceiling! I wonder, how do flies walk on the ceiling? I'm gonna need wings and spider legs!
Wings, spider legs, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station! Shrinking down! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure! Hey, Devo! I think I know that fly! It's Horace!
Hi, Blippi! How's it going, pal?
How did you get on the ceiling?
No, it's easy! Watch this! Ta-da!
Wow!
Yes, sirree! The ceiling is my own personal dance floor! Skip it, bit it, dip, 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 dip. Now you try!
Here goes! Whoa! Why can't the Blippi-mobile stand on the ceiling, too? What's the trick?
Here's the trick! You've got to stick!
Stick?
Mm-hmm. You see, my feet make a super sticky glue that helps me stick to the ceiling. Here, try some.
Don't mind if I do. Here goes. Whoa! Oh, now I stick to the ceiling too.
Look at all that mess! Oh!
Oh! The glue has us stuck in place!
That's because you're not doing the fly leg twist!
The fly leg twist?
That's right! Fly glue is so strong that we have to push ourselves off the ceiling to walk! Like this!
Like this?
You got it! Now let's hit it! Do the fly leg twist, do the fly leg twist, and get your feet unstuck when you go like this!
We did it! And I have the answer to my question. How do flies walk on the ceiling? Fly legs have a special sticky glue that keeps them stuck to the ceiling. Upload answer, Debo.
Well, I'm off to eat a little bit of dinner now. See you later, Blippi!
Bye-bye! Holy smokes! A volcano! That's right, Debo! When a volcano erupts, smoke and hot lava come out the top of it. Hmm, I wonder, what makes a volcano erupt? Great idea! We'll go inside a volcano and find out. I'm gonna need wings, spider legs, and the heat shield.
Wings, spider legs, heat shield, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi Mobile is ready for adventure. Let's go through the side vent into the volcano. Whoa, whoa! Oh, it sure is hot in here. Whoa!
Hey there, I'm Maggie the Magma Monster.
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Debo. We want to learn what makes a volcano erupt.
You're in for a real treat, Blippi and Debo. Speaking of treats... Below us, deep in the Earth, the planet's heat is melting rocks into liquid, also known as magma, like me.
You're right, Debo. It is like one of our favorite games. The floor is lava. Whoa!
Magma becomes lava after it erupts out of the volcano.
Whoa.
So I guess I'm the floor.
Whoa! We're getting higher!
That's because the more rocks melt below, the more magma rises here in the chamber.
Hey, I wonder where this goes.
Look out, Blippi!
Magma!
Phew!
That was close! Maggie, you almost filled the whole cavern now.
I sure do. And as I grow, the pressure inside the volcano builds until we push through the crust or the top of the earth.
Hold on! Whee!
Ah, much better.
Maggie, what a blast! And I got the answer to my question. What makes a volcano erupt? A volcano erupts when the hot magma inside it builds pressure and bursts through the surface of the Earth. Upload answer, Debo.
That was fun, Blippi. Hope you loved it.
We did. Bye-bye, Maggie.
Achoo!
Thanks. Achoo! Huh, something is making me sneeze. I wonder, why do people sneeze? Yes, it's time to find the nearest nose and see what happens in there. I'm gonna need rocket boosters, a grabber arm, and spider legs.
Rocket booster, grabber arm, spider legs, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. Shrinking down! The Blippi Mobile is ready for adventure. Woo-hoo! Into a nose we go. It's like a cave in here. Hello! Hey, it's me, Blippi. Who are you?
My name's Petunia, and I'm a piece of pollen. I may be small, but I can make big things happen.
Like a sneeze?
You got it. When I'm around people, I bother them. And I especially like bothering noses. Come on, dance with me. Oh, don't worry, it's a nose. It's not going to bite. Plus, it's fun.
So, this will make someone sneeze?
This is just a start, since a sniff is coming. Watch out.
That wasn't that bad. It looks like we're in a jungle.
This is all hair. It's here to keep pollen like me, and plus other things like dust particles, out of your nose. Well, it won't work. Oh, it's fun to be irritating.
Will this cause a sneeze?
I hope so. Ooh, now a tissue's coming for me. Tickle more!
Is the sneeze coming?
It is! Na 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 na!
Oh no! Boogers!
We did it!
Yes! And I have the answer to my question. Why do people sneeze? People sneeze when tiny things like pollen get inside their nose and irritate it. Upload answer, Debo.
Okay! See ya, Blippi!
Bye-bye, Petunia!
Activate Blippi Station! It's time, get up and shout. I wonder what we'll learn about Blippi!
Whoa! A giant construction site! Let's go check it out! Hard hat area. I wonder, why do construction workers need to wear hard hats?
Hey, I'm driving here!
It's me, Blippi, and this is Debo. We were wondering, why do construction workers wear hard hats?
Oh, well, hello there, Blippi and Debo. My name is Christopher. Christopher Crane, how you doing? Uh-oh. Here, put these on. You'll need them.
Okay.
Come with me. I need to bring these beams to the other side of the site. I can teach you about hard hats on the way. Here. Construction sites are very dangerous, and a hard hat helps protect your head from many risks. Like, you know, swinging steel beams. Whoa, watch out!
Whoa, that was a close one.
That's why we gotta be careful, you know? Kareem, how you doing? That's my buddy Kareem, he's a good guy, very tall. Come on!
Hi, Kareem!
Hey, Debo, look out for those pipes.
It's a good thing you're wearing your hard hat, Debo.
Hard hats are great at protecting your head against bumps, you know? Still got a ways to go. Hop on.
Yeah! Whoa! Look at all those construction workers all the way up there.
Oh. Sounds like lunch to me. But remember, there are dangers all over a construction site. You gotta be careful when walking below workers because you never know when something might...
Debo!
Fall. All right, stop goofing around. We got a job to do.
Let's go. Uh-oh.
Yeah!
Thanks, Christopher.
All right, let's get this job started.
Yeah!
This is the hard part. Gotta line it up just so.
Okay?
Hey, look! You helped install the last beam!
Yeah! And I got the answer to my question. Construction workers wear hard hats to protect their head from bumps and falling objects. Upload answer, Debo.
Hey, I got another job to do. Thanks for your help, Blippi. I'll see you later!
Bye, Christopher!
Activate Blippi Station! It's time, get up and shout. I wonder what we'll learn about Blippi!
You look like a fireman! Now you look like a construction worker! You're a natural cowboy, Debo! I wonder,
what is it like to be a cowboy? Let's find out. I'm gonna need a grabber arm.
Grabber arm confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi Mobile is ready for adventure. Hey! Do you know any cowboys?
Whoa there! Howdy, I'm Hampton the Horse. What brings you two down to these parts?
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Debo. We're here to learn what it's like to be a cowboy.
Well, you certainly rode into the right ranch. Giddy up! But first, we've got to get you looking the part.
All right!
I see you got your hat on, partner. Looking good. Here, Blippi, grab yourself a hat and a bandana. See, cowboys wear these wide-brimmed hats to protect themselves from the sun and the rain.
Ah, much better.
Now you looking good.
Yeehaw, cowboy!
But they're also useful for gathering water when you need a drink.
Cool! Ooh! Whoa! Uh-oh! Whoopsie!
Cowboy hats are also good for moving a cow in the right direction. Yeah. Here you go. Here you go.
Hey!
No worries there, Blippi. Being a cowboy is so much more than just having the right clothes.
Like what?
Riding horses is a big part of the job. It's how cowboys got around before cars, and it allows us to herd cattle without scaring. Hop on.
Let's ride! Maybe we should slow down. Oh, I think I'll stick to the Blippi Mobile.
That's actually perfect, since we have loose cattle to wrangle. We gotta spread out and move in the direction we want the cows to go, toward the pen.
This way.
Let's get a wiggle on. That means let's go.
Yeehaw!
Yippee! Well done, Blippi. You wrangled those cows like a real cowboy.
Being a cowboy is hard work.
Sure is, but it makes the day worthwhile.
Yeah. Thanks for helping me find the answer to my question. Cowboys wear big hats, ride horses, and wrangle cattle. Upload answer, Debo. Thanks for making us feel at home on the range.
Anytime, City Slicker.
Activate Blippi Station. It's time, get up and shout. I wonder what we'll learn about Blippi.
Cool, a fire truck. You're right, Tabs. It does have a really long ladder. I wonder, what's it like to be a fire truck? Great idea! We can catch up with that fire truck and find out.
Well, hi there. I'm Frankie the fire truck.
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Tabs. Great to meet you, Frankie. We were wondering what it's like to be a fire truck.
It's a big job. You always have to be ready to help. And I am. They call me a first responder, which means I'm the first one to arrive at any emergency.
That's great, Frankie. Hey, will you show Tabs your really long ladder?
Sure. I also have a lot of other special equipment. Check it out. I have many ladders and hoses.
So cool! And also fire extinguishers and first aid kits?
I do! And hammers and cutters to open stuck doors.
Ooh! You also have nets?
Oh yeah, I have nets in case someone in trouble needs to jump to safety. I don't only put out fires, I also rescue people and animals. sounds like a cat needs help. It's in a tree. Come on. Blippi, you go up and get the kitten down.
I'm ready.
Hey, kitty.
Kitty, I'm here to help. I'll pick you up and carry you down. I couldn't get to her.
There's no giving up, Blippi. We must rescue her.
Good idea, Tabs. We can use the net. Kitty, this way. We did it.
Frankie, we got a code 1171 on Main Street. There's a fire. Please hurry.
I'm on it. Time to go. My siren can get loud, but it helps people to know to get out of my way. Don't worry, Blippi. I got this.
Yeah! That was amazing, Frankie. You put that fire out so quickly. The fire's flaring up again. I'm gonna need the water hose attachment.
Water hose confirmed.
Yeah! We did it! The fire is out! And I have the answer to my question. What's it like to be a fire truck? Fire trucks are first responders to fires and other emergencies. They carry lots of equipment, like hoses, ladders, and nets. They also have a siren to alert people that they're coming. Upload answer tabs. Bye, Frankie. Thanks for letting us help out.
Bye, Blippi. Bye, Tabs. Stay safe.